Today, I'm going to tell you 10 things that you need to know before you get your engine overhauled. So the first thing I'm going to say is I'm really happy I did this. It was well worth the time and the money, and now I have an outstanding engine, and after the initial break-in flight of over 30 hours, my plane only burned 3/4 of a quart of oil in 30 hours, and I am overwhelmed, I am happy, and I am ecstatic. Now, I have a lot of information, and it may be a little bit more of me standing up and talking than you're used to, but there's a lot of information I want to share and a lot that you're going to need to know. The first thing you need to know is this takes time and you have to plan it accordingly. And there are many, many steps. And I wish it was just as easy as making a phone call, plopping down your credit card and saying, I want a new engine, and it's done in a week. I wish it was that simple, but there's a lot more to it than that. I overhauled my Lycoming O320 Echo 2 Delta, and it took exactly 3 months from the time I dropped the engine off in Fort Lauderdale till the time I did my initial break-in flight. And I was involved in every step of the process that I could be. I really wanted to stay on top of it, and I'm glad I did. Number one, the first thing you need to do is research, and research and more research. Here's the deal. You're going to be spending a lot of money, close to $30,000. Any way you look at that, that's a year of college tuition or a cheap Mercedes or any other nice car. Either way, that's a ton of cash. So be wise. Number two, go with a reputable engine remanufacturer. I used Airmark Overhaul in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and I was thrilled with their customer service, and I was absolutely thrilled with the outcome. I highly recommend them. I was involved in as much of the process as I could be, and I was calling them from time to time, staying on top of the process, and initially they promised me 5 weeks, but there were delays due to the supply chain and all other things messed up because of COVID. So everything else, that was kind of a drag, but the worst thing was my crankshaft failed inspection and it needed to be replaced. That was an extra $5,000 and an extra 4 weeks. That was tough news when it came in, but it only hurt once, and now looking back, I have a new engine, so it doesn't really bother me. Number three, you want to go with a top shop because you need a warranty. If you get a local mechanic to do it or a friend to do it, it may be cheaper, but if it goes sideways, you are stuck. And we all know things happen. You need a large company to stand behind their work. This is also a project that needs to be done right, not on the cheap. You're making a major investment in your life, really, and safety is a top priority. You need a licensed FAA repair station that has all of their I's dotted and all of their T's crossed. So do your background research on them. Google any complaints filed, and even go as far as talk to former clients. Remember, there's nothing wrong with asking for references with any shop. After all, you're paying probably your first year's salary that you made right out of college on this one, and it's really important. So don't be afraid to ask for references. Number four, make sure you replace the oil cooler and all the hoses. This is really important. While the engine is out, take care of all these little things. Like my cabin heater never really worked well, and I was finally able to get that working. It was all mechanical and it was all in the linkages, but with the engine removed, we could finally pay attention to the linkage and find the problem. Number five, don't forget to look at your electrical and make sure your voltage regulator is up to par. Mine wasn't, and I had to replace it. So do this while the engine is off. It's really important to get your voltage right. Number six, replace your alternator if you need to. A new engine needs a new alternator. Number seven, now here's a note on upgrading to an IO360 from an IO320. Do even more research here. You will need an STC for this, and that can get very complicated. As I was planning originally to upgrade my engine in my 1968 Cardinal to an IO360, but at the end of the day, I realized everything from the firewall forward was gonna have to be replaced, and it was just cost prohibitive. It really would have been cheaper for me to sell 221 for Yankee and buy a newer airplane, and I couldn't find a clean STC. And even worse, I ran across a couple of really shady outfits. So there's two words here, caveat emptor. There are a lot of sharks out there and they bite. So if it smells bad, it usually is. Number 8, don't be cheap. With this kind of money being spent, get the nicer cylinders, get the better alternator, and get your prop overhauled as well. Also, if you time it right, you can get a new interior as well, and while the plane is sitting there waiting for a new engine, it's the perfect time to put a new interior in. Number 9, don't try and save money on the shipping by transporting the engine yourself. Pay the extra $600 or $700 for shipping. I rented a truck and went out and got the engine myself, and as I was driving back, two things happened. It started to rain very heavily all the way back from Fort Lauderdale to Tampa, and thank goodness the engine was shrink-wrapped. And as I was worried about that, I was thinking, it occurred to me that if anything happened, I got into an accident or somebody hit me, I probably wouldn't be covered insurance-wise. So it was really stupid of me to transport the engine myself, because if anything happened, I wasn't going to be covered for a $30,000 engine that's sitting in the back. So pay for the shipping. I thought I'd save a little bit of money and a little time, and I was wrong. And luckily, nothing happened. Number 10, remember, you are spending $30,000 on a new engine. Spend $5,000 more and protect it with an engine monitor. This was money well spent for me. I have a total knowledge of what's going on with my engine while it's operating, from the cylinder head temperatures to the exhaust gas temperatures, fuel flow, fuel pressure, and everything. I can dial in everything I want to get the exact CHTs down to the manufacturer's specifications and really focus on taking good care of my engine. This will also help the resale value of the airplane. Overall, don't be cheap on this process. You are basically giving your plane a heart transplant, and you want to spare no expense on that. Don't be cheap. You are basically getting a new airplane, and you will have years of peace of mind knowing that you did it right. So thanks for watching. I hope this helped. I hope you learned something. And if you are over 50, you know what to do. Get up and get in the air. Thanks for watching.